We saw the mid Renekton. Like, they did not play standard Korean League of Legends, so at the same time, you know, a lot was learned here, but I think they probably weren't happy with how it went. But we might not see them play like this against Damwon Ki, or maybe they take what they learned from the hard parts of this series and use that against their series against Damwon Ki. So there's still hope for that to be a good series on Saturday.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not the win you expected.
No, it was certainly feeling like a little bit more for fun than it otherwise would. But, you know, there are a lot of teams that are close to a lot of people's hearts that do like to have a few of these fun games. And Harmo Life Esports is going to join those ranks. So maybe this is going to be something that Harmo Life Esports isn't going to be too affected by. But, you know, this game was all about Morgan being absolutely massive. But that early gank towards the top lane, that flash over the wall from Peanut, that all-in play, I don't think was necessary. You know, you can talk about risk reward, and that was definitely way more risk than the potential reward.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, it felt like sunk cost fallacy because he felt like he had to.
Yeah, no, exactly.
He had to do it because he used his flash, and it still looked like it was potentially going to be very good, but unfortunately, just misjudged the situation a little bit. And there were a few team fights here throughout the kind of later parts of the mid game where Nongshim were almost able to really turn the tide of this game, but unfortunately, they just could not kill Morgan in almost any of these cases. Like, he did so much on his own that it was actually just crazy. Like, in this case as well.
I mean, he survived. Morgan. He didn't die all game.
Yes.
Just a big old crocodile. And then, he might have died at the end in that party on the fountain. I'm not sure.
Yeah, maybe. Well, Han Life dropped the ball a little bit on the end of that fight. But, yeah. You know, at the end of the day, like, Morgan had no fear because he was so fed. So he was able to set up so well for these fights. And it's like Chovy in him that did the majority of the damage. And Def was just there to, like, chase down targets and kill them. He's like, oh, okay, see, now you guys are giving me so much space. I can do literally whatever I want. I'm not afraid. And every single fight was Nongshim hoping that they did enough damage counter-wise that Duckdom could press R and turn the tides. And he usually only traded one kill back. And they ended up losing a few painful fights in that later stage of the game. And,
yeah.
Well, this is one of those fights.
This is also, like, an example of Rich having yet another really difficult game. Like, this was Chovy outplaying it. But before this, you know, Rich really did have some rough moments. We're going to have a listen to a bit of the fiesta that happened here on the fountain.
I think Morgan does go down, like, in
the
I don't know who's sitting there, like, hey, let's finish the game.
Yeah, I think Morgan was like, I'll tank for you, Def, so you can get out, and then they both died.
Sorry, so why am I not doing damage to the Nexus? Does get in the end and take it out. But take a look at the post game and the damage outputs here. Look at Chovy's damage. Like, that's what I'm talking about. He was unpunished because the Renekton gave so much space in every single fight because he was so fed and had his Hysterics so early that Chovy was able to.